"It is I. It is Helga. Dost thou not know me? 3 minutes ago we were speaking together yonder in the veranda." "That is a mistake," said the stork. "You must have dreamed all this." "No, no," she exclaimed. Then she reminded him of the Viking's castle, of the great lake, and of the journey across the ocean. Then Stork Papa winked his eyes and said, "Why, that's an old story which happened in the time of my grandfather. There certainly was a princess of that kind in Egypt once, who came from the Danish land, but she vanished on the evening of her wedding day, many hundred years ago, and never came back. You may read about it yourself yonder, on a monument in the garden. There you will find swans and storks sculptured, and on top is a figure of the Princess Helga in marble." And so it was. Helga understood it all now, and sank on her knees. The sun burst forth in all its glory, as in olden times. The form of the frog vanished in his beams, and the beautiful form stood forth in all its loveliness. So now, bathed in light, rose a beautiful form, purer, clearer than air, a ray of brightness, from the source of light himself. The body crumbled into dust, and a faded lotus flower lay on the spot on which Helga had stood. "Now that is a new ending to the story," said Stork Papa. "I really never expected it would end in this way, but it seems a very good ending."
"And what will the young one say to it, I wonder?" said Stork Mama.
"Ah, that is a very important question," replied the stork.
The Races. A prize, or rather two prizes, a great one and a small one, had been awarded for the greatest swiftness in running. Not in a single race, but for the whole year. "I obtained the first prize," said the hare. "Justice must still be carried out, even when one has relations and good friends among the prize committee. But that the snail should have received the second prize, I consider almost an insult to myself." "No," said the fence rail, who had been a witness at the distribution of prizes, "there should be some consideration for industry and perseverance. I have heard many respectable people say so, and I can quite understand it. The snail certainly took half a year to get over the threshold of the door, but he injured himself and broke his collarbone by the haste he made. He gave himself up entirely to the race, and ran with his house on his back, which was all, of course, very praiseworthy, and therefore he obtained the second prize."